which is where I lived, amen? And I wasn't in my right mind, can I be honest with you? I'd had a few too many. And I remember that there was, if you were here when the Super Bowl was here last time, we had an ice storm. And I was leaving the club, not in my right mind, on I-20 in an SUV. And the next thing I know, boom, I hit the side of the wall. And my car went, the truck, I was in an Expedition, it went right. And there's no rail on the right, amen, on 20. But I hit something that kept me from going this way, and I went back this way. And I'm thinking to myself, all of these things are going through my mind. I'm like, there's no rail on the right-hand side. And I swerve back to the left, and the front of my truck hits the rail again, boom. And I feel my truck spin around. And I go back to the right. There's no rail. There's nothing there to hold me there. Amen. But when I opened my eyes, I began to thank God that not only was I still there, but Lord, I thank you for being that rail. Amen. I was brought up in a house. Amen. I knew I may not have been doing everything I needed to do at the time. And not long after that, I said, Lord, I thank you for saving me. I have to serve you, and I have to serve the way that you want me to serve you, not on my own time, but according to what it is that you have for me. And I make no qualms about who I was and what I did in my past, because my past makes me who I am today. And all I can say is so many times, amen, when we get to this point in our life, so many times when we love ourselves, because I looked in the mirror this morning, I love myself. I looked in the mirror this morning, I said, girl, you the one. But it hasn't always been like that, amen. You can't judge me by the chapter that you walked in on, amen. Because you don't know what happened up until this point. You don't know when I used to look in the mirror and I couldn't stand to look at the person I was looking at. You don't know when I used to look in the mirror, amen, and I was so down on that person that I allowed other people to mistreat me. But when you love yourself, ladies, when you love yourself, see, you can stand on Genesis 1 and 27 that we were created in his image. And if I'm created in his image, amen, and he didn't allow anybody to mistreat him, why am I going to allow anybody to mistreat me? So if we can just let go, amen, of all the mascara and our cute makeup and everything else, if it run down my face and it run on my white shirt this morning, I'm all right with that. I'm all right with that. One more time, say, I'm worth it.
I'm worth it.
I'm worth it. Amen. Worth it. Hallelujah. In the house of the Lord.
Amen.
We're going to ask our very own evangelist, Erika Snelling, to come and give us a warm welcome this morning. Y'all give her a hand as she comes forward. Amen. Hallelujah. Put your blessed hands together on today, for we serve an amazing God. And I'm just grateful to God. I'm so happy in my sanctified soul as I sit out and I look at the women that came out to be with us on this day. We serve an amazing God. We serve an amazing God. And I stand in awe of his glory. I stand in awe of his presence. I'm just happy. I got my mama here, y'all. I got my mama here. Glory to God. And I'm grateful that you joined us on today. I got my co-workers here. My managers here. My co-workers are here, y'all, in the house. I got so many sisters. And I'm just grateful that you took the time out to come and be with us on today. I got my childhood friend here. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. I was at a little dance, a little wind down Wednesdays, and I seen her and I said, hey, I got somewhere I want you to come. And she said, I'll be there. A lot of times we open up our mouth and we say we're gonna be there, but we just brush it off and we don't go. But I'm grateful that you showed up on today. What I can assure you, anything that you need from God, you'll get it today. We have been praying faithfully for an entire month for this conference. And I know God is already here, y'all. Can you feel it?
Amen.
Glory to God. God is already in the house. And it don't matter what you're going through. Leave it alone. Let it go. Leave it alone. I don't care what it is. Because we serve an amazing God that's going to do amazing things on today. But I can't get it for you. You got to get it for yourself. So I welcome you. The place is beautiful, but I'm telling you, when the Spirit of the Lord hits, it may be some tables that get knocked over. Tablecloths may go flying. If your wig fly off, if you lose your shoes, it's okay. It's okay, because God has brought me from a mighty long way. God has covered his daughter in the midst of all the pain, and I'm going to give him the praise because he's so worthy and because he's so deserving. And I dare you to give him some praise this morning. If you don't get nothing, put none in, you won't get nothing out. This is the truth and transparency women's conference. A lot of times we put on the mask. We want to hide behind the makeup. In the clothes. And I can fake a smile. Even though I'm messed up on the inside. And my heart may be broke. But today, ladies, we're going to get butt naked before our Father. And he is going to heal us. He is going to mend our broken hearts. So I just welcome you on this morning. I don't know where all of that came from. But I welcome you. And I pray that you just let go and let God on this day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And now if we can have Minister Linda Johnson come and bless us in prayer this morning. Amen. Amen. Come on now. Come on now. Amen.
We can do better than that. Come on and put your hands together. Oh, I feel the Spirit of God in this place this morning. For this is the day that the Lord has made. Pastor Sabrina, you set the atmosphere here. Yeah. God used you mightily this morning. When I was coming in, I said, who is that praying? And when I heard her voice, I said, good God Almighty. Come on, when you come in with great expectancy, you don't have to wait on anybody else. You can just come on in here and give God some praise. You can set the atmosphere. Come on, I see some women up in here that's true about what they are going through, and they don't care what nobody says. The woman of God said, we are right.
Glory.
She said, we are right. Yes. We are worth it.
Amen.
Y'all stand up just for a minute if you don't
mind. Glory.
Stand up. Give your sister a hug. Set the atmosphere in here. Somebody been going through something. Somebody told somebody and somebody didn't. Yeah, he kind of shake our body. Oh, but the Spirit of the living God is in this place. He said, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Oh, come on, come on, come on. Ah. Stand on your feet. Remain on your feet. Get in that posture of receiving from the Shato Kobashe. Receiving from Akano Boshe. Receiving from the Lord. Ah, beautiful black women of God up in here. Beautiful women of just women all in general. Because see, my sister over here, and I don't want to exclude anybody. We all sisters. We don't have no color. We don't see color. But I thank God for each and every one of the sisters in here this morning. Because truly, this is the day that the Lord has made. And I feel like warning, but I'm going to hold my mule. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for me, my soul cries. Because we don't know the hell. See, people, we just see all the beauty in here. But we don't know what happened just an hour ago. You know, last night, some of us had to press our way here. We had to turn over. We had to take a licking and keep on ticking. Come on, somebody. Oh, but we standing here. We standing strong. We are binding together a cause that cannot be broken. See, they used to say women can't work together, but the devil is a liar. We are strong when we are together. United front we are. Ah, let us pray. Eternal Father in heaven, our Father and our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Father, we thank you for this time you have given unto us. God, we don't take it lightly, but we count it a joy and a privilege that you have allowed us to come together this morning. God, I'm talking about unifying in the spirit. God, we thank you this morning, God, that everybody that's supposed to be here, they are here. They're coming with great expectancy. Huh? And when we come, God, expecting you to do it, we trust that you will do it. God, we thank you even now, as you have already prepared the woman of God, Apostle Claudette Dixon. God, we thank you for putting a word down, a word down in her belly, that when she speak to us, God, let us be receptive to hear what thus says the Lord. And God, we take the word that is given, God, and go back and apply it in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, we honor and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen.
Amen, amen. Woo, I feel like dancing. Amen. I used to dance for somebody else. Amen, come on now. We're going to get loose this morning, but I feel like dancing even if my clothes come off. Amen. Y'all remember that? Even if my clothes come off, I feel like dancing this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Now, we're going to ask you to stand to your feet just one more time as Emmanuel Cook blesses us in some praise and worship. Amen. Look, I didn't even know this was next. And I said, I feel like dancing. So if y'all see me over in the corner, y'all don't pay me no mind. Amen. Because when I get busy with the Lord, I ain't paying y'all no mind. I love you, but I ain't paying you no mind. Amen. So don't do it for me. Amen. But Emmanuel, if you will bless us in praise and worship this morning. Amen.
Awesome. So I just want to check the temperature in here. So far, it looks like it's at about 93 degrees, and we're trying to get to 100. I'm just trying to gauge, should I be Emmanuel or should I just be professional and just sing the songs? I'm trying to see who I have in the room. So if I can just see who's willing to lift their hands before Almighty God. So if we have worshipers in here who are not ashamed to lift up their hands and serve an awesome risen King, serve a mighty King, serve the one who's concerned about your life. Serve the one who died on the cross for you. Serve the God who spent generations, thousands and thousands of years trying to win your soul, trying to win your heart. Do we have any yes people in here? Anybody who can just say yes to his will and yes to his way? Yes, we will go wherever you say, God. Yes, we will obey. You know, we serve an awesome God, and I just want to say, who would serve a God like this? We all love him. Now, can we just do something different? Can we just close our eyes and say, who could serve a God like this?
We want to live for the glory.
give you all that you'll ask according to his will. That's the key. It has to be according to his will. God, we thank you for your presence, God. So we honor you, the king in the room, the only king in the room, the only king in the room. And in the spirit, Father, we look up and we honor your crown. We cast ours down so that we can focus on you. So whatever that you're willing to say to us, Father, if you're willing to say it, we're willing to listen to it. Thank you as we enter this time of praise and worship, Father. We thank you just for kissing us on the forehead just now, Father. Just
glory, glory, glory.
That you're here. That's the difference between you and Satan. You're omnipresent. You're everywhere at all times. Satan can only be at one place at one time. He's not omniscient. He's not omnipotent. He can't be in my house and your house at the same time. He can't be in my church and their church at the same time. Even in a dark room, as soon as you turn on the light, there is light, and you no longer see darkness. Satan represents the kingdom of darkness. When we walk in, he flees. We don't even have to ask him to go, because where light is, darkness can't dwell. So he's not even here. Can we just dismiss that little punk from our mind? Can we just dismiss him? He's not coming for you. He's not coming after you. God, we thank you for your goodness and your mercy. We thank you, Lord, we thank you for prepping the hearts of the people, Father, as we enter this time of praise. God, you're so awesome. You're so awesome. You're so awesome. You're so awesome. So if you just join with me in this song, I'll keep it short because that took too long. You know, in the kingdom of heaven, you know, he doesn't run on time. So that was probably like 1 second in his course, like 1 second. Are y'all ready to do that when we get to heaven? We literally sit around the throne just singing holy and holy, worthy is the Lord God Almighty, for eternity. Isn't that awesome? You know, I don't know why I'm sensing this. So I'm sure there are a lot of mothers in the room.
Amen.
We all have mothers or had mothers. And if you've lost your mother, just think about the moments that you got to sit at her feet and just listen to her wisdom, if she was that kind of mother to you. Oh, Lord, but I feel this too. Even if you didn't have that kind of mother, the crazy thing is God is everything to all people. And so he'll be your mother and your father and your comforter. And if you weren't able to sit at your mother's feet, you can sit at the feet of God. You can read the book of Proverbs and see all of the goodies and the gifts that he's given to you. I mean, oh, he's so rich in mercy. He's so giving. He's so giving. He's so giving. And I like to receive. Do y'all like to receive?
Glory.
If I were to give out $10,000, who would receive it?
Glory.
I'm telling you, your God owns a cattle on 1,000 wheels. He owns every single resource that you can be believing for. And I don't know why I'm doing this, but maybe somebody has a bill that they're afraid will be met this month. Maybe they're in a mortgage. But I hear God saying in this moment to cast that on me. I didn't design you to worry. I didn't design you to fret. I didn't design you to be concerned about your life. That's my God. That's why he says, cast your cares on me, on the one who cares for you. Father, we surrender. surrender to you, Father, so we can get all that we are supposed to get tonight or today, Father. So we thank you for your love. Man. Woo! So let's turn up. Put your hands if I like it.
Your mind.
Because
Come on, God, just need us a few more. Come on, we almost there. I feel her heart warming up this morning. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, if it's just one, thank you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord God. She's ready. She's ready. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for my sister this morning, Lord God, whoever she is. If we can have Ann Lovelady come forward this morning. Hallelujah. 2 years ago, I went into the hospital. Well, I went to get a colonoscopy. And I had to go into the hospital to get it. Okay, when I went to get the colonoscopy, the doctor punctured my colon. I had to have 3/4 of my colon removed. So I started praying. I stayed in the hospital for 8 days. And that was the first time I stayed in the hospital. They didn't know they had punctured my colon. Then I got sick. I had to go back. I was in there again for another 8 days. I had to go in for emergency surgery. And that's when they removed 3/4 of my colon. But when I went to surgery that night, I had to go about 12 or 1 that night. I wasn't nervous.
Amen.
I was calm. I was really calm because I knew God had me.
Amen.
I woke up intensive care, and I was like, Lord, what am I doing in here? And he said, you're not on a machine, and you're still living.
Amen.
I said, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Next thing I know, I see my bishop, Bishop Keith Young. He comes there, and I know he had told me he was going out of town. And I'm like, Bishop, what are you doing here? He said, I just had to see you. My family had him praying. My church family, everybody was praying for me that night. I didn't even know I was that sick, but I made it through.
Hallelujah.
March 30th this year, I had to go back. Now listen, when I had to have this emergency surgery, they put a bag on me. And I don't know, you all don't know what that's like to walk around with a colostomy bag. You just have to pray. Just pray that God will help you to do it because it's awful. I wasn't used to nothing like that. Never took medicine in my life. Very healthy. So March 30th, they wanted to reverse it. I said, okay, I went in. They reversed it. I stayed there about 8 days. It didn't take. I had diarrhea every day. I had dehydration every day. I was dehydrated. The next time I went in the hospital, they told me, you gotta stay. You gotta stay until we can do surgery again. But we can't do surgery right away because you just had surgery. I was like, oh Lord, every morning I listen to Stan, the song Stan. I listen to the morning prayer at 6 o'clock. Every morning God woke me up at 5 o'clock for devotion. And I had devotion every morning. So then they did the surgery. I was in there I stayed in the hospital then for 26 days. After I had the surgery, the second day, it was like I was in labor. I started having really severe pain. They gave me narcotics, would nothing help me, did nothing help. And the only thing we could do was pray. My family was in there, everybody was praying. Only thing we could do was pray. Okay, I want y'all to see this picture. I'm sitting on the bedside commode, throwing up pain and just praying. So, one of my nurses came in, never seen a day in my life. And I had told my sister, I said, she kept calling. My sister is a minister praying. So the next time I told my daughter, I said, don't let her call. Let her boyfriend call, which was a bishop, the next one. Let him call and let's pray. He called. The nurse came. She said she was coming in. We was already praying. I looked down. The nurse was right here on my side. She was crying and praying. Tears was just flowing out of her eyes. I've never seen anything like that. But guess what? God walked through that room.
Glory.
He came through there. I was in no more pain. I had been in pain from 9 that morning to 8 that night. God came in that room and he showed up. And look at me now, y'all.
Amen. Amen.
I ain't
amen.
So bad. But it's no more pain.
Amen, amen.
I am a miracle, y'all.
Amen, amen.
She, I just wanted to say this. She is a living testimony. She is the strongest woman I know. And not only did God heal her, but my daughter, who is 23, has the same thing that my mom has. She went to the doctor the other day. He said, I don't need to see you back until next year. Because you're healed, honey. Not only did he heal my mama, he healed my daughter. Anybody that's going through anything, God, let's say, heal her.
How many of y'all know the oil flows down? Come on now. The oil flows down. Amen. Hallelujah. We're believing it for somebody else, not knowing that we're so close to it. Amen. Some of it might just fall on us. Amen. But you got to be around the right folks now. You got to be in the right place. Hallelujah. Esther was in position. Come on now. She wasn't out of place. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, prepare yourselves to be blessed this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Prepare yourselves to be blessed. We're going to welcome a young lady, amen, to worship and dance this morning. And if you wouldn't mind, please put in your hands together, amen, or a group of women is a unit.
Everybody clap your hands, everybody do your dance.
We rock. We rock. Everybody go. We rock. We rock. Everybody go. Work hard.
And it's titled Transparency and Truth. Hey y'all, it's mighty nice to see each of you. Look at you. Some of you looking a hot mess. When was the last time you got a full night's rest?
Uh-oh.
My sister, please don't take what I say in a negative or derogatory way. See, I'm just like you. I'm here to be transparent and true. Who'd ever thought their husband would cheat? No way, Jose, not me. Broke down to the bone, feeling lost and alone. As a single mother, one income, feeding mine and the neighborhood kids was no easy task for me. There was times when I felt small and weak. There was days my cupboard was bare, days of fear and depression, feeling as if nobody cared. To be honest with you, and staying transparent and true, sis, I'm a hot mess too. I can tell you, life for me ain't been no walk in the park. There's been many days I felt lost in the dark. But I must confess that in all my mess, God our Father still chose me to bless. The moment I realized I had a choice to use my voice, speaking the word of God over my life, was like cutting through the darkness with a knife. I heard someone say, it won't always be this way. But I needed to watch what I say and stop dwelling on pain of the past and mistakes that didn't last. Instead, as you live out your life's plan, just simply hold on tight to God's unchanging hand. It's easy to do when you're transparent and true.
All right.
Amen. Come on now. If we're going to be transparent and true, my sister looking good this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. We would like to have another testimony. Evangelist Warmack, will you come and bless us this morning? Y'all give her a hand. Come on, give my sister a hand as she comes. Amen.
Praise the Lord, sisters. Oh, come on and bless the Lord, sister. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I just brought my Bible with me. I'm not going to be long. I just want to read you. I want to share my testimony. But it appears that the Lord is doing something that is marvelous in the house today, which we can all rejoice. Amen. All of these women here. And I believe the testimonies has kind of summed up this. Here's a little scripture for me. In the Song of Solomon chapter 8 and verse 8. I just looked at all the women and I thought about what I've been through and I thought about where I came from and where I've been and where I was before I had been. And I just began to think about what is in the house. And the Lord sent me to the book of the Song of Solomon chapter 8 and verse 8. It says, we have a little sister and she has no breasts. What shall we do with our little sister in the day when she shall be spoken? For I think about quite a few of my little sisters that's in the house today, and they got breasts. But we still got some little sisters that have no breasts. They're sitting here. I'm not talking about the natural thing. I'm talking about the thing that gives sustenance in the spirit. I'm talking about the thing that will nurture somebody in the spirit. I'm talking about the one that believes that I'm mature in the spirit. But we have not yet arrived. We've not arrived. Because if you have not been through some of the bumps and the bruises of another, if you have not been, if you've been telling God to move the mountain, if you've been telling God to move the trial, if you've been telling God to heal the body, but have not thought about the healer is already in you. I believe Micah chapter 4 and verse 9 says, why are you crying? Why are you lamenting? Why are you being weak? Is there not a king inside of you? Yeah. Every sister in the house today can reach over and touch another sister and say, I don't know how your breast's doing, but I got you, baby. And you want to reach over and tell somebody else, I don't know how your breast looks, but I got you, baby. We are blessed up in here today. We are blessed in the house today. That's my testimony. My testimony is that the enemy he would try cancer with me. Glory be to God. Not breast cancer, but in my little finite mind, all sicknesses and diseases are lumped into one thing. So he might come at me with cancer. He might come at you with sugar diabetes. He might come out with another with lupus. I don't know how he's coming at you. He came at my sister just a month ago, and she happened to be here in the land of Georgia from Massachusetts today. I was hoping to bring her with me. She has stage 4 pancreatic cancer. But what the enemy does not know, I find out, is there not a king inside of me? And when I asked God to heal that uterine cancer that I had, I went through surgery just to remove the uterus. And then they told me that I was going to have chemotherapy and radiation. Oh, I didn't care where I went. You know, when you're with God, you don't care what you got to walk through. I walked through the fire. I walked through the flood. I walked through sickness. I walked through diseases. Because the chief end of every man is to bring glory to God. I stand here to tell you today, fine as wine. Oh, I am. You say that we are. I already thought I was. I already know I am. You got to know who you are. If you're going to possess anything with God, you got to know who you are. Hallelujah. I'm writing a book called Give Me My Mountain. And I don't care what is in it. I don't care what the opposition is. I don't care what he try to trick. He go from family member to family member to family member. But I got news for you today. I am healed by his stripes. I didn't take no chemo. I didn't do no radiation. I did whatever God had was planned for me. But I'm here today to tell the devil, my sister might not have no breath. She might be a wall. But I'm here to build her up with my testimony that God is a deliverer, God is a healer, God is a savior, God is a master, God is a Lord. He is my every.
Amen. And don't she look good as she goes back to her seat? Amen. Y'all better recognize you in the midst of queens in here today. Hallelujah. You don't see my crown. You don't see my crown, because when I walked in here, I came with a crown on my head. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Now we're going to prepare our hearts and our minds for another dance. Amen. Is Tamia, are you ready? I saw her over there. Amen.
I want to sing this song tonight in memory of my late son, Prentice Brown. He used to call this his favorite song. This is to you, baby. Oh, yeah. Amazing grace shall always be my song of praise. Ooh. It was.
Rejoice. You all heard some good stuff in this place today. And God is not a respecter of person. You ready? You better be ready, because the woman of God, hallelujah, who I have the pleasure, the honor, hallelujah, of introducing, the mouthpiece of God, hallelujah, the voice of God for the hour, hallelujah, prophetess Claudette Wilson. I'm so grateful for this woman of God, because when I tell you, she hears God. Not only does she hear God, because all of us, I pray, hear God, but not many of us are obedient to say what God says or to do what God says do. But this woman of God, if God said it, she's gonna speak it in the name of Jesus. Prophetess Claudette Wilson is originally from Foley, Alabama. She's a mother, a mentor, a prophetess, a pastor, and sought-after motivational speaker. She became one with the Father God over 20 years ago. Somebody say longevity. Prophetess Claudette Wilson has since traveled extensively across the United States, bringing the transforming gospel of Jesus Christ to people of all color, culture, creed, and nationality. She has built ministries, churches all over the United States. She has been featured on TBN, in various books and talk shows over the years. She now oversees various ministries and churches under the fellowship of International Eagles Fellowship Incorporated. Hallelujah. After our psalmist, evangelist Vanessa Ratlin, the next voice that you will hear will be that of prophetess Claudette Wilson. Put your hands together.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Don't y'all get quiet up in here.
Glory, glory, glory.
Don't get quiet, don't get quiet. Your body ought to be light. You're filled up with food. Now your pocket is a little bit lighter, but God's going to fill it up again. Amen. 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 To God be the glory. Y'all look so good.
Glory.
Give yourself a hand.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Y'all was able to get up and put on your own clothes this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Didn't nobody have to wipe no dribble or nothing like that off. You were able to do it yourself. Amen. God is an awesome God. He's a mighty God. He's a holy God. He's a righteous God. He's a right now God. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. I asked this young man, did he know the song? He said, no, ma'am. I said, okay. But that's all right, too. We're going to give you what God gave us. Amen. I've had trials and tribulations, amen. Unexpected situations, living here below. I've had friends to turn their backs on me, yes. And leave me standing in the cold. I've been hurt in the church as I attempt to do God's work by people who call themselves saints. Many times I felt like giving up, but the Spirit says, no, you can't. You see, the Lord, He puts us through a lot of things we don't understand. And everything that He allows, there's a reason. 'Cause in my life, the devil gets no glory everywhere. I'll tell the story. How God has a way of turning things around. He meant it for my good. God meant it for my good. Past the test of time, and like a tree by the waters I stood. But through it all, God gets the glory. Everywhere I tell the story, how God worked it out just for me. The devil meant it for bad, but I'm so glad God meant it for my good. The gossip, the lies, the tears in my eyes have worked out for my good. I passed the test of time, and like a tree by the waters, I stood. And through it all, God gets the glory. Everywhere I tell the story, how God worked it out just for me. The devil meant it for bad, but I'm so glad God meant it for my good. Oh, He meant down, and I knew that he would. Now I know no defeat. I'm strong when I'm weak. I gave me a song. Now I must sing on. The devil meant it for bad. But I'm so glad God, he meant it. Yes, he meant it. That old devil meant it. He meant it for my bad. But I know no defeat. I'm strong when I'm weak. I know no defeat. I'm strong when I'm weak. I know no defeat. I'm strong when I'm weak. Because the Lord did it. Yes, he did. He did it. Yes, he did. He did it. Yes, he did. God did it. Yes, he did. You can talk.
Come on here, because I've just outgrown this place. Come on here, you just outgrown that place. Oh.
raised you up for such a time as this. I know you can't see it right now because the enemy wants you to have scales over your eyes. Because you look a neighbor right in the eye. Say, I'm no longer blind, but now I see. Come on here. I didn't see it at first, but now I understand. This song's making better by and by.
Anything I grow has to change an atmosphere. Come on. Anything that you like grow, you got to have room. Come on here. You say enlarge your territory. Anybody feel like enlarging your territory? Y'all play too much. You just stretch. Come on here. What you thought was going to cause you to have a setback, it gave you a greater comeback.
Trying to say, I know what what you're saying, mother, the blessed one. Come on here. But I got some people here that need to give birth today. Come on here. You need to have this baby. Before some of y'all came here, you was about to abort your blessing. Come on here. You told God, said, God, I'm going to pay for an abortion and get it over with. But ain't you glad that you came in the house of God? Ain't you glad that you came with other women that can encourage you and pray on you? Don't bury it just yet. Don't throw it away just yet. Don't get rid of it just yet. God says still life in there. Come on here. Ain't there life in the blood? Thank you, Pastor Westmoreland. Let's go into the word. Amen of God. The whole side. I feel a prophetic wind. If y'all would kind of let me have this aisle, because I like to walk. I'm not staying on station. I like to move. Hallelujah. God is good, ain't it? What you say about it?
God is what?
What? No, just when you get your check on the first. Come on here. No, when you get paid every 2 weeks, come on here. No, when your husband acts right. But he's good. And all the time.
God
is good. Could you lean over your neighbor and say, neighbor? God's going to do it one more time.
God's going to do it one more time.
Another neighbor said, neighbor.
Neighbor.
God's going to do it.
God's going to do it.
One more time.
One more time.
Amen. Glory to God. You may have your seat. Amen. I bring you greetings right here in Atlanta, Georgia, amen. Not a stranger to the word of God. Amen. Neither the people of God. I am a people person. I love God's people because that's what we're called to love. How could you be a leader and not have love? The Bible said that they'll know that we're disciples by having love one towards the other. And can I tell you something, the lady right here with the gold right here? God is going
to
heal your family line.
Hallelujah.
There's been a lot of discord in your family.
Glory.
A lot of fighting, but God said, glory. He's bringing peace. Yes, he's going to give you some peace. He's going to give you some peace. Hallelujah. Like the river now. He's going to give you real peace. That way, glory, you can sleep real good and not have to worry about everything that's going
on
in your family.
He's going to heal
generations in your family. Hallelujah. Yes. See, y'all play too much. You got to pull on the woman, man of God. Amen. Glory to God. So you can get your blessing.